those hands together and glorify the Lord.
Yeah.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Kind of quiet this morning. How many of you had a really good weekend, a good holiday? Didn't eat too much barbecue and watermelon and red soda and all that kind of stuff, amen? I want you to look over at your neighbor. Look at him. Smile at him. Tell him good morning. Some of y'all ain't even know. Do you even know who's sitting beside you this morning? Just tell him good morning. How you doing? God is great and he is greatly to be praised.
Yes.
We come to tell you this morning how great our God is. Amen?
Yes.
Hallelujah. Do you know God is great?
Yes, he is.
Oh, great God. Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus.
Walk with me, Lord. Walk with me.
Don't you want him to walk with you this morning?
Walk.
Walk with me, Lord.
Walk with me, Lord.
I know you want. praise is right. Worshiping God is right. And hearing God's word is what we need. And today God has chosen a vessel to bring his word. Today I'm going to talk about a man that I have the utmost respect for. When I looked in the Bible to talk about Job was an upright man and a man full of integrity. You know, you can know scriptures as an elder. You know, you probably can shout and dance and carry on. Amen. But I'm like God. I want to look at your heart. God said, I'm not like you, man. You look at the outer appearance. I look at a man's heart. Amen. See, you can't hide your heart. And I've been knowing this man here now for at least a little bit over 5 years. And his character, amen, has always been the same. A humble man. The way you see him today, you'll see him like that tomorrow. He loved his family. He loved his church. He loved his pastor, and he loved his God. Yes. A man of complete integrity. He's committed. Yes. He's faithful. Yes. And he's a right arm to his pastor. Okay. And he's a warrior for his God. Yes. This man I'm talking about is none other than Elder Harold. Amen. Amen. He's the type of man that, you know what, Elder Harold, and I'm saying this from my heart, and I told Dad this before. I won't follow no anybody. I don't care. You better ask my wife. I don't follow no anybody. I don't care what kind of credentials you have. If you're not doing what you're supposed to be doing, my family and us, we walking up out of here. Amen. But Elder Harold, I could follow you. You could be my pastor. And I'm not going to say that about everybody because you got a collar on you. Well, you know, I'll let God sort it out. Amen. But this is how I feel towards this man. And what's in my heart is going to come up. You can ask my wife over there. She have to get on me by my mouth. Oh, well. Amen. So this man, he has a word. And that's how our hearts open to receive him and receive the word that God has in him. Amen. Because he is a worthy vessel. God don't choose no anybody. Amen. And superintendent not going to choose no anybody. And so the next voice you're going to hear besides mine will be that of Elder Harold. Dad's right-hand man, Dad's assistant, my brother in the Lord, and your assistant pastor, Elder Cedric. Amen? Amen. Elder Harold, I'm sorry. Forgive me. God bless you.
To do what must be done, I work and work until he comes. A one wonderful. never change. Me. Washed away. Wonderful child.